Hi pals, welcome to my channel Mood Budgets. If you're new here, welcome. If you're a returning subscriber, thank you so much for coming back to watch yet another video of mine. This is my journey from being skint, living wage to wage, overdrafts, credit cards, being completely unprepared for any life events, to being a bit more savvy with my money, a bit more in control and a bit more aware of what's happening in my bank account. And the one thing that I have learned on this journey is to check my bank account on a regular basis. I actually do it every day. At some point I will check my bank account and just make sure the transactions in it are as they should be, and that I know where my money is and what I'm spending on. So today we are just going to do a super quick closeout. I think we're heading off for a drive somewhere very shortly, and I'm still sitting in my pyjamas and it's after lunchtime, so I better get a move on. I still have a bit of an issue with a frog in my throat, so if I do start coughing, I apologise, and I do need to take a wee drink every now and again. So let's just get straight into it. Sorry, moving the camera. So for this week, we're closing out the week of the 13th to the 19th of June, so that's today. I am not going to spend any money when we go out and about today because I'm not even going to take my purse with me. Because I don't have any money to spend because I've spent it all. Our rollover was 547.42. I brought in £5 from my Etsy jar on Hyperjar, which is just where the money's sitting just now. I'm not taking a wage from it, I'm just going to make sure it's sat there so that anything I need to pay is covered and that I have money there for any taxes and all the rest of it. Obviously I'm getting a good amount of orders and I'm really, really, really appreciative of it. But it's not enough to be worrying about bringing a wage in. As long as it pays for itself and I'm enjoying doing the makes, then that's all I'm looking for at the minute. So it's fine. Sinking funds, I'm using £50 from sinking funds. So £30 of that is from the budgeting envelope that I emptied. And then I've used £20 within my budget, which I'll show you shortly. Car insurance hasn't come out yet. It was due to come out on Saturday, so it'll probably come out on Monday. So I've just taken that off and I've added it into next week's budget. The 200 Club is sort of like our village raffle. Pay for £4 a month, so £1 a week basically. And I think I've been doing it 3 or 4 years now, never won a thing. So maybe one day my luck will come in. I'll probably end up winning a bottle of whiskey. Gifts, I used £20, so this is the extra £20 on my sinking funds up the top there, and that was just to get some extra Father's Day bits and bobs, like cards and wrapping paper and a few bits of chocolate, that kind of thing. So in total I spent £24 in sort of my bill area. The gifts obviously should be down in my sinking funds or whatever, but I just feel like there should be another box for them personally. So they've just fired them there, there's plenty of space. So taking the £24 away from the £1,344 up the top of the page here, that leaves me with £1,320.46 to take care of my envelopes. Let me zoom you out just a bit. So I actually only put £40 into, well, put £45 into Hyperjar instead of £50. I used £5 for the dog, so that left me with £40 for my groceries instead of £45, which was originally planned, which explains why I felt that money was a little bit tight this week. But I managed and it was fine. My diesel came to £95. The tank was just on the red and I topped it up fully and it took £95 to fill that up. So absolutely devastated when it hit £95, but what can you do? I need the petrol for work or the diesel for work, so that's just how it is. My spending, I spent £5, I think that was on sort of like juices and things, can't even remember what it was on, but I spent it anyway. Miscellaneous was £5, and that was, I went shopping with my mum to get her food shop for the week, and I added a few things to the basket or the trolley, so I paid her back for the £5 for that. Work spending, I spent the full £10. I think it was £9.05 and I left the 95 pence as a tip. This is not something I can continue doing because that's, £50 in a month on work is a lot of money to be spending. So I am going to have a word with my boss again and see what can be done. Postage, I only spent £5, but I've got orders to package up and put in the post tomorrow morning. So I've still got £5 left in my budget from what I put in up here. And then next week I'm just going to put £5 in again, but that still leaves me with actually £10 of Etsy money to use. So that's grand, and I totally appreciate every single order I get, and I'm absolutely loving making them, and I hope everybody that's received an order is enjoying it as well. Electric, I put £10 in, and that's just sat in my purse ready for whenever I need to put the electric in, because I've still got money on the key at the minute, so I only want to do that once that's emptied. So that could be at the end of July, but at least the money will be sat there ready, because I may have to put it in before I go on holiday, depending on where the meeting is at. So in total, my envelopes were came to £175. I deducted that away from the 1320, leaving me with 1145. I then put £130 into sinking funds, so £30 of that was from the budgeting one that I put into Weekend Away, and then another £100 went into all the different envelopes, which are over here. So I just put them into these ones here, and that would have been in a cash stuffing video. If you want to go back and watch that, feel free. I set up a direct debit for Aqua, and I wasn't sure when it was coming out, but I've managed to find out that it comes out on the 29th of June. So I didn't have to spend on that. So that leaves me with 1,015 still. Don't know why I didn't fill in this column. So then I took away the £10 out of my McMoo challenge, and that leaves me with £1,005.46. So I actually have £1,046 in the bank, and I had £5 in cash, which was a rollover from the Etsy postage, which I added back into my budget this week. So yeah, that is basically our closeout. Everything went as it should. I felt really weird spending this, my spending a miscellaneous money. I almost felt wrong to spend it, but I had to remember myself that that money was there for a reason. I needed it, and I enjoyed the outcome of what I bought with it. So it's important for me to remember that although I often stuff it and don't use it, I put it there because it's within my budget to allow me to spend it on anything I want to spend it on. And that's, you know, it doesn't have to be anything specific. But yeah, so that is all we have just now. We're on 8 minutes. So what I'm going to quickly do is, I've been making some orders this morning. So before I package them up, I have been asked a few times to show people what I make. So let me just grab them before I pop them away. So we have, the first order is a rainbow 50p challenge. I haven't looked out the zipper envelope, but they'll get a zipper envelope like that as well for a package it. So that is there in the rainbow. This is proving to be the most popular print. Everyone seems to really love the rainbow print, and it is very cute. So that's the first order. In fact, you'll find that there's actually three of these to come, so it's another 50p challenge. And that's the same. And with this top order, there was also a rainy day savings challenge. So that has basically got the welly boots on the back and denominations of 5, 10s or 15s. And so you just tick them off as and when you save them. And I think you can save £150 in total, which is a nice little amount, not too big. And then the money just sits in there. Now, whoever's ordered it says, sorry, you're not getting the £10. But yeah, so your money just sits in there. So 5, 10s or 15. I quite like this one myself, to be fair. I'm almost tempted to switch that out for my treat envelope, because £150 is quite a good amount In fact, I might make one for myself, and again, at some point in time, this will be available in the cow print, the butterfly print, and the daisy print. But I just have to get organised. And then we have another order of a 50p challenge. This is in the pink cow print, so again, it saves £25 and 50p's. And again, you can get the challenge on its own if you have your own money box, and then you can get the wallet to keep the 50p's in if you wish it. It's just a little bit extra for a wallet, obviously, because I need to supply that. So, and I have asked the lady to show you these because these are a little bit more personalised. So these are envelopes, but I have asked her permission to show these, so and she's more than happy for that to happen. It's just they have names on them. So we have our cash envelopes. So we made six. Let me see if I can get it without this sun shining on it. So we have a green butterfly, and that is basically again the same thing. The money just sits in there. So we've got green butterfly, we've got yellow butterfly, and a red butterfly. And there will be other options of colours as well, but I was allowed just a free hand, so there's that. So that's the butterfly print, which I think is really, really pretty. And these are the ones I have in my purse as well, the same print. So we have the yellow. It's probably my favourite, to be fair. It's really nice and vibrant. And then we have daisy print. So we've got a grey. Again, the same thing. The money just goes in the envelope and it's hole punched, ready for a binder. A nice purple and a nice peachy colour. I think these are really lovely, and these are just exactly the same as what is in my own purse. So I have the blues in here just to match my my wallet, basically. So these are the different shades of blues, and that's more of a purple. I mean, all these options probably won't be on the website because there's, you know, a limit to how many colours I can add on there, but there will be a good variety. So that's when I say that the you know, all the 5p challenges and the 50p challenges, sorry, and the other challenges that I offer, like the rainy day challenges, they'll all be available in these prints, and there'll be a selection of colours. I just have to make the decision as to what colours I use. So that is another order. And then the last thing I'm going to show you, which hopefully will be added to my store this coming week, is two challenges that I've made. So we have these were made with, they're just like samples that I was trying out, so they're not made correctly, but these are Catch the Butterfly Challenge. So they will have, when I make them, they will have like an envelope attached to them, but I didn't want to waste the laminate for these. But that's how they would look on the front. So it's basically just Catch the Butterfly, and on the back we have the little butterflies. And it works out to the same as the McMoo Challenge. So you've got the 5s, the 10s and the 20s. And you would just save whichever one that you wanted to save. So that is what they would look like when you save them. That's Catch the Butterfly. So they will be getting added to my Etsy store at some point. And then the last one, which I have just done, will be the Daisy Chain Challenge. And these will either come just as they are like that, or they will also come with a zippered envelope, because these will have coins in them. And then basically you would just get your marker pen. I don't know if I have one here, but No, I don't know where it's gone. I don't know if that one would work, but you would just, as you collected the money, you would just join the daisy. You can't really see that on the camera, but you just join the daisies up with a marker pen to make a chain. So that is the two challenges that I will be adding to my website at some point. So that was my Etsy website. These are just samples. So yeah, and they will come with a different backing, something on the backing just to see what it is. Yeah, I hope you like them. Let me know your comments. But I will go now because that's me and I on to 15 minutes. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you all have a lovely weekend. Take care and goodbye.